Everyone. So officially, I would like to welcome all of you who've gathered here today for the launch event of First Choice Rebar Shapes and Solutions. On behalf of the entire Tharaldson Group, we are very thankful to all of you for taking out time on this lovely weekend evening. We had actually got wonderful weather today, so it's good to have company of your kind selves here. We still have some guests awaited, but they have requested us to start with the proceedings because they're stuck in traffic. So moving on, I'd like to thank you once again to have made it out to be here today. Thank you. Now I'd like to request our chairman, Mr. Vinay Agarwal, to please welcome our senior guest, Dr. S. N. Rao, General Manager, RINL, by the presentation of the bouquet. Dr. S. N. Rao has flown in from Visakhapatnam to be a part of this event today. A special thanks to him. We are thankful to all the other members who have also come here, and I'm aware some people have, as I know, Mr. Ladar has just come back from Bangalore and has still made it out to be a part of this event today. Mr. Divakar also, even though he's not keeping that well, the GM from L&T, he still made it out to the event today. So we're thankful to all of you for having made these special attempts to be a part of our launch event. It means a lot of us, a lot to all of us. To begin the proceedings, I'd request the senior dignitaries, along with our chairman, Mr. Vinay Agarwal, Dr. S. N. Rao, and Mr. R. Ramachandran, who has been associated with us, who has been associated with us since, I believe, I cannot remember because I was too, probably I wasn't even born since the time he's been associated with us. And he is now our chief mentor and advisor, and it is because of his guidance and support, along with the guidance of Mr. Niranjan Roy, who is unfortunately not a part of this event today, that we have been able to come up with something like this. So I request all three of you to please light the lamp and inaugurate the event today. Thank you. Now I'd like to request Dr. S. N. Rao, General Manager, RINL, to please come up to the dais for the keynote address. Thank you.
A very good evening to all the distinguished guests. It is a privilege to me to be here on the launch of the First Choice Rebar Shape and Solutions, where with Mr. Vinay Agarwal, our good friend, CMD Tharaldson Group, and Sri Samir Agarwal, sir. This is a real occasion for me. Our CMD was supposed to be here, Mr. Madhusudan. He had some meetings in Delhi, so I had to represent him. He has sent all his best wishes to the group, and he wanted that this venture to be a success. We have got long association with Vinay Agarwalji, so it is really he has taken a step further from our main producers, whatever we are producing. Today's scenario, steel scenario, if you see, the customer satisfaction is the important thing, because 20 years back, there are only some three producers, and There is iron and steel controller, and all those things are there, and whatever these three main producers gives the material, the customers has to accept. And down the line, after 10 years, there are the competition is there. Private sector has come up, the main producers, including JSW, JSPL, Tata Steel, and all these people are also aggressively marketing. And further, the rolling sector also has grown up by leaps and bounds. So this has increased the, on one side there is a price war, that is a different aspect which we have to tackle in terms of the quality and the service. So the quality and service have become the most important factors in today's steel scenario. So one is all producers are trying to maintain the, improve the quality, give quality products to the customers, and concentrating on value-added steel. On the other side, the, regarding the service, there is a post-sales service is a must, and what customer wants in different, his requirements have to be fulfilled at his doorstep. That is what the service outlets have to, service centers have to be, to gear up to take the, that challenge. So in that direction, first shape and first choice rebar shape and solutions has taken a step. I congratulate once again Mr. Vinay Agrawal and his team for taking out this step. At RINL, you know, as RINL Visakhapatnam steel plant, we have started with 3.4 million tons capacity, and thereafter we have recently expanded our facility also, and we will be coming up with three mills also have added, that is wire rod mill and again special bar mill and another structural mills we have added to the facilities, and our production will be going up from 3.4 to 6.3 million tons in the next 1 or 2 years. So there will be a lot of products will be coming up, and the demand also will be there, and also we have to service the customers with respect to the requirements which throws from these products. So even in fact our CMD was just 15 days back, he was asking us to see that how the service centers at various points can be opened up, or whether you can have any tie up with the service centers, and these aspects we are also examining it, and a committee is also looking into it, so that the customers after, I mean, there are the big all captains are here, architects are here, builders are here, and the big construction companies like L&T are here, and they are having their own service centers, of course, but there are small customers also are there where we have to serve them with the quality product and the required way they want it. So these things definitely RINL also is going to look into it, because we produce basically 88, 10, 12 in coil form, and also our mills, new mills have got provision to go up to 20 mm in coil form. We will be soon launching that this thing also. So these things will facilitate. So if the service centers are there at vantage points in the country, these things will facilitate to help and serve the customers better. So once again I congratulate Vinay Agrawal ji and his team for taking this bold step forward, and I wish them all the success in the future. Thank you.
Thank you sir for those motivating words. Your words of motivation are actually what we needed to start this event today, where we are launching these results. So, to take the evening forward, station wherein I'll be showcasing you what the group is about, the Tarachand Group, followed by what the First Choice Rebar services that we are going to be presenting, and how you are going to benefit out of the services that we have set up at Taloja. So Tarachand Logistics Solutions Limited, That's our parent company, which is providing enterprising, efficient, and economical solutions to different companies, different projects across India through our different verticals. We were established in 1969 and have grown into a professional organization from being just a steel trading unit back in 69 to being a professionally run organization spread into three verticals working across the Indian landscape. The company verticals that we are currently engaged in is warehousing logistics, where we are providing professional warehousing management services to companies like Steel Authority of India Limited and Rashtriya Ispat Nigam Limited. Then we have moved on to crane deployment, where we have been deploying cranes to different projects, infra projects across the landscape of India for projects that are being managed by L&T. There are projects by the other MNC companies. And we have been providing rebar processing services as well. Up till now, we have been doing it on site with clients like L&T and Reliance, where we have done rebar processing as job work at the L&T IIT Hyderabad site, as well as with Reliance at Jamnagar. For warehousing logistics, we have been the leaders in warehousing logistics for the last three decades, and our leadership has helped us in winning numerous awards. We have won the Best Managed Warehouse Award for Sale for three consecutive years from 2005 to 2008 in Bangalore. We also won the Best Managed Warehouse in Chennai in 2009-10. We were recently again recognized for our meticulous planning by the Chief Project Manager of Rashtriya Railway Vikas Nigam Limited, RVNL. And he had mentioned in his letter specifically, this is due to the meticulous planning of Messrs. Tarachand Logistics Handling the Solutions Limited and their team at site. Over the period of time, we have developed the capacity of handling rail rake in efficient way in very short period without any damage. So this was one of the biggest achievements in the recent times that we have had handling facilities that we gave to RVNL. We were also, for our warehousing logistics solutions, we have been given the best maintained stockyard in the last year by Rashtriya Ispat Nigam Limited. We are currently the consignment agents for Rashtriya Ispat Nigam Limited and Steel Authority of India Limited in Mumbai. We have handled the maximum number of yards for Steel Authority of India Limited throughout India over the last three decades. Apart from warehousing logistics, we have a fleet of 300 plus cranes as well as trailers, ranging from the capacity of 14 tons to 200 tons, wherein different services are provided at the sites. As I was mentioning earlier, that we have worked with different multinational companies like Reliance, L&T, and if you would see here with BGR Energy Systems as well. So this is a depiction of the different activity that our cranes are capable of doing or our fleet is capable of doing. The prime reason for our success, we believe, is that we have stuck to our motto, which is safety in toto. What we actually mean by that is we have ensured that we have kept our manpower and machinery in the most safe and secure manner. We have ensured that all our staff is covered under ESIC, which is the Employee State Insurance, which enables medical cover to our staff. We were the first ever in this country to introduce reverse camera in new generation cranes in India. We were the first to also implement safe load indicators in our cranes. People might say that safe load indicators were implemented probably earlier than we did, but we introduced a system of password to be entered by the supervisor so nobody could bypass the system. So this was the first innovation done by us in the country again. We have laid a very huge emphasis on preventive maintenance. There is a team that is specially dedicated to the same, because for the success of any project where our machinery is deployed, it has to be working in proper condition and it should be maintained at all times. All of these efforts are leading to a safe and productive work environment for all our clients. This here depicts the letter that we received from the original equipment manufacturer, which is Action Construction Equipment, which also certifies that we were the first to get the reverse cameras introduced into the new generation pick and carry cranes. In addition to what I was talking about, with safety, that we have pledged to safety in toto, we have ensured that all our operators and technicians on site have always worn the personal protection equipment which is a very big necessity in ensuring accident-prone, accident-free operations on site. One of the biggest reasons for us to have attained the success that we have in the last three decades is that we have always stuck to being a leader in innovation. What is highlighted here is the innovations that we have done in the crane deployment sector with regards to introducing the ACs and cabins of new generation cranes for the first time again in India. We were the first to introduce high security number plates for the cranes so that the number plates cannot get tampered. Earlier, there have been issues, as we were advised by the RTOs, that people do indulge in that, so we ensured that those activities were not at all possible. We were also the first to introduce the GPS system on cranes. Failures might have happened earlier, but for cranes, we were the first to introduce them to ensure that wherever the cranes are working, we have a back-end team that monitors the working of our cranes on site. So we are also aware if there is any laxity on the part of operators or the team there, that does not happen. If the crane is in operation through the GPS system, we are able to handle that. If the crane is in transit from one site to another, from the plant to the site, the client can also have a look at where the cranes have reached. So that will be, they are able to maintain the location of the cranes accordingly. Apart from machinery, it's not just the innovative techniques that we have come up with machinery. We have also ensured, because we understand that for the success of the project, it's the machine and the manpower that have to work in tandem to ensure the success. So for that very reason, we adopted the Industrial Training Institute in Panchkula in association with Government of Haryana 3 years ago. And in that institute, we have a strength of 400 students who are being trained and skilled to ensure that they handle these equipments in the best of manner. We ran a placement drive for 160 ITI diploma holders and ensured their placement for such activities. The students, they do not just go through the theoretical study. We ensure that there is a practical tours of those at the OEM sites or at sites where the work is happening, so the students can actually understand what it means to handle these equipments in the real world. We have the tie-ups with the OEMs, the original equipment manufacturers, to provide the training to these students so that the training is brought in by the people who have actually created the machinery, which also adds to higher skill of our manpower. All of this that I was talking about has led us to work with many different projects, work for many different principal employers across the country, and today we are present more than 30 locations across India, providing crane deployment services, warehousing logistics services, or our rebar processing services. And this addition that we have today is the new addition that we are doing to our current diaspora of activity. Apart from being into logistics and handling, we have another vertical, which is a group company, our sister concern, which is under the brand name of Pallavi Hotels and Resorts. This hospitality unit that we've got three different locations already across India, with Panchkula in Haryana, Navi Mumbai, and Alappi in Kerala. We've got two hotels in Panchkula, one 74-room hotel in Navi Mumbai, and one houseboat, currently three-bedroom luxury houseboat in Kerala. We also have a 10-acre floating villa resort coming up there so that we can serve our guests the luxury of being in traditional homes of Kerala. This is a snapshot of our different properties and what we are serving there. Our services helped us to get the ranking of number one value hotel for our Navi Mumbai hotel, Pallavi Avida, by the world's recognized website, which is tripadvisor.com. We are making sure that our rankings and our service are at the highest level while we are ensuring that the value to the customer is such that he feels that he is at a value for money hotel. That was just a brief introduction about the group as a whole. Now this is the part that we have gathered here for today. The First Choice Rebar Shapes and Solutions that we have launched at Taloja. Before I tell you what exactly we are producing or what solution we are providing to you at the Taloja plant, I would like to spend a few minutes on few current problems that are being faced by the infrastructure and construction industry. To start with, all the projects that we have, when we have discussed with people who have had projects in the past or are currently into projects, or what we read in the news as well, do run into hidden costs or over project overrun costs. What we have identified is the reason why this is probably happening. As you would see, this is an actual site photograph to show the high wastage that happens on site. This is an actual site photograph that is showing the very high wastage that occurred on a construction site for constructing a residential project in Mumbai. This is a Mumbai photograph. The good part is they've actually kept the wastage in a very defined manner. Usually the wastage is actually scattered throughout the property. So this, at least they are aware of what the wastage probably is. But otherwise, if you would see, the wastage is not even possible to actually come to know at other sites. The other photograph in this slide is showing you the idle manpower or the excess manpower, which usually is present at all sites because the contractors do not have a proper control system on the manpower that they bring in to their sites. So this idle manpower leads to a lot of additional costs, which is the labor management hassle. If you would look at it, there is the cost of bringing up the labor colonies, or providing for their provisions, or managing their statutory requirements, which leads to hidden costs that are actually not catered to or considered when it is initially conceived. Hidden costs are one thing, and the other related aspect becomes the delay that happens in projects, which also leads to the project overrun. Now, why are these delays happening? Again, what we understand is high labor hassles on site, because the management of labor is so inefficient that the productivity is not at all possible to be achieved in the way that one would really want when the project is conceived. Inventory management of steel on site. The steel that is brought to site is very difficult to manage because of, again, it being a high pilferage and high wastage item. And the inventories are also not manageable because when you require the material is easily either not processed by the labor on the time, or it has not yet reached the site. So there's a lot of mismatch happening on these sites leading to these delayed projects. As I've said, low productivity, because all of the activity, all of the steel cutting and bending, because if we refer to steel per se, all of the steel cutting and bending is happening through the traditional manual methods, which are not at all reliable for their efficiency, because all the manpower does is it takes its own free time, and when they want, they might not even work. So that leads to low productivities on site. And in a later slide, I'll also show the difference of how much time is taken to produce one single ring manually versus how it is done in the automated machinery. Of the three problems, this is the third that we realize is a big issue that currently a lot of the sites face. What we read in one of the IIT Kanpur studies, it clarified that earthquake resistance of any structure comes from the 135 degree hook that has to be there when the steel is tied to the columns and structures. This is again a very is a live site photograph, which is showing that there is no 135 degree hook that is placed. If you would see the circle here, it shows that there is no bending of this last end to create the 135 degree hook that is otherwise required, making the structure very making the structure very brittle. And if there is by any chance earthquake that happen, it leads to the coming down of these buildings. I have discussed with you started that there are three problems that we have identified are primarily leading to a lot of headache for the project teams, to the developers, to people who are involved as stakeholders in the project. How do we overcome this? This is a revolutionary solution that we propose to you. First choice, rebar, shapes and solutions, the plant, the fully automated plant set up at Taloja. It has a current capacity of doing 60,000 metric tons per annum through different machinery and technology that we have deployed there. I'll just run you through the machinery and the technology that we are using at the plant. This is a shear line. which is used for cutting and bending of the higher diameter steel. Higher diameter steel ranging from 16 mm to up to 40 mm. It can actually probably do higher cutting as well, but not yet used in India for those dies. The double bender, this is used for the putting the bends on the both sides, or if a single side is required. The beauty of the plant is that our double bender is associated right next to the shear line. So the material from the shear line that has been cut and needs to be bent moves automatically to the double bender without any manual intervention. So that again is showing you the kind of productivity, the efficiency that the plant can achieve. These are the stirrup making machines. This machine is where the stirrup making, the automatic stirrup making happens. These are the coil holders to your left, where the coils that are placed from the primary producers. Now, the one other thing with the difference you would see between the traditional methods and the methods deployed at the plant is in the traditional methods, you cannot do the stirrup formation from the coil. Because one, a lot of the people are using secondary producer material. Secondary producers do not have the provision of making coil. That is only possible through primary producers. Two, even if they're using primary producers, they're first getting the steel straightened by the primary producer or by an outside agency and then bringing it to the site for the site people to handle it. So in either way, in the manual traditional method, it is not possible to use coils to come up with rings. Why are the coils important, or why are these machineries important? In my subsequent slide, you would see the kind of difference that happens in the time taken by the machines to produce the rings versus the time taken, or the excessive time taken by the manual traditional method. We are also adding on, apart from the three machines that I just showed you, we are also adding on coupler making machines, which are to be installed in the first week of April. That will be an added service for all our clients and projects, wherein we will be also doing the coupler activity from our plant itself. As I was saying earlier, I would show you the difference between how a manual ring bending is done and the automatic thing works. So we'll just show you a video first of the manual rings, how they are made on site. So if you would see here, he has first created this specific arrangement where he would do the bending. This is again a very unsafe way of doing it. This is from a construction site in Mumbai. He is further creating the rings by using material, if you would have seen at the starting of the video, that was already cut to the length that was required. So there has first time has gone into cutting the steel to the requirement for him to actually make the ring. Now he's completed making the ring. That was actually 50 seconds to make one ring. Manually, we just saw that it took 50 seconds to make one ring. And here I'm showing you the automated process of making the ring. So one thing you'll notice here is there are two coils simultaneously working on this machine. The two coils means the two rings can be simultaneously produced at the same time, which is not possible in the manual way of doing it. Now here you would see two rings are being produced simultaneously. This is a 1 minute video, 60 second video, showing the production of rings. The total number of rings produced in 60 seconds is 20. So now I'll just give you a comparison once again, going back to the manual versus the automatic. The manual technique was able to produce one ring in 50 seconds. Here we are producing 20 rings of the same size, same shape in 60 seconds. Again, just don't get, think it is just the difference between 50 seconds and 60 seconds of 20 rings. Those 50 seconds, there was an additional time period consumed in actually cutting the material to the length that was required to make those rings. So the comparison is many fold of what we are actually seeing. So this is the kind of productivity difference that we are talking about between the manual and the automatic process. So that's one clear example of how it's happening. I'll just take a second to welcome Mr. S.M. Maheshwari. He was stuck in traffic, so he's finally been able to reach us. He is the chief engineer in Central Railways, and he's taken out the time to grace the occasion today. We are really thankful to him. So please, welcome. In continuation to what I had shown you in the previous slide, which was the differentiation between the manual way of doing, making the rings versus the automatic way, these are the rings produced. So here you would see in the automated FCR stirrups, you are getting the precise 135 degree hook, which is required for this structure to be earthquake resistant. Now, if the earthquake resistant structure has to be there, you have to have the precise 135 degree hook. One might say this is possible through the manual effort as well. Yes, it could possibly be done, and it is being done also. But again, the angle produced is never, at least as far as what I have discussed with the people, some of them are also present here, it's not able to actually achieve 135 degrees in the manual method. Two, the time consumed is even much more. So again, if I go by the productivity comparison, it's again a many, many fold difference between the automated and the manual process. If you would see to the boards on the right, it shows the different shapes and sizes that we have produced through these machines, and a lot of them are showing the 135 degree precise angle that has been achieved through these machines. What are we gathered here for today? Ultimately, what are we giving to you? Or what is in this for all of you who are sitting here? This slide and a couple of more slides, because I actually fell short of space on this slide to show you the kind of benefits that I can pass on to you from FCR. First one is the no wastage on site. No wastage on site, when I say, is now when the material that you are requiring for your construction activity is getting produced at our plant, you do not require any unprocessed material on your site. What we will receive is the drawing from your RCC consultant or the structural engineer, whatsoever you call him, and we will be using our own in-house team to come up with the bar bending schedule required for your site. So bar bending scheduling is another benefit which I'll come to later, but using that, we'll be producing the steel that is required at your site. So you do not have any wastage that happens at site. If you would reflect on the first slide that I showed on the difficulty space, the huge wastage that we were able to see, that will be totally zero for the site. In addition to just saving the wastage, because all the material is being produced at our plant, you would just need the inventory that is actually required for the construction at that moment. So you get just-in-time inventory. So there is no inventory cost, or there is literally very little inventory management that you have to do for the otherwise very strenuous activity that happens through the traditional method. We are producing steel as per your requirement from the BBS. So all the pieces that are produced are countable, because it's either rings or sizes or short length that are required for construction in countable pieces. So again, it becomes very easy to track the inventory. What we have shown earlier is the high productivity that you get. So if high productivity of steel cutting and bending is happening for you, we believe that is one of the major factors that will help you in ensuring an on-time project completion. An on-time project completion automatically means that you are reducing a lot of your other costs which are otherwise not seen. Again, I would draw your attention to the boards here. The complex shapes that can be produced through these machines are simply impossible through the human manual method. Why these shapes are possibly important? An RCC consultant or structural engineer might understand better, that they probably can come up with better building designs which can reduce the material, which can reduce the concrete that needs to be used, which can reduce the effort overall to construct those buildings. So these complex shapes can be very useful in again bringing down the cost and passing on further benefits for every site. Bar bending schedule detailing, as I said earlier in the very first point, that we have the in-house team that would do the bar bending scheduling automatically from the AutoCAD file received from your RCC consultant or structural engineer, and we would be able to produce the VBS that would be helpful for our plant production, and the same VBS would be in such a format that the site people can also understand it, because we do not want the confusion that the plant is producing the VBS something else and the site people understand something else. So that point again was brought up by one of our in one of our discussions, and we have worked on bridging that gap by giving another facility, which I'll come to in the next slide. The final point on this slide is that you would not require any space and infrastructure on site, which is related primarily to the excessive labor, which is otherwise present on site because of the manual and the methods that are used, plus cut and bend the steel on site. Even if you're using semi-automatic machines or the manual method, you need to provide space. In Mumbai, I was told when I came here about 5 years ago, the biggest luxury you can get in Mumbai is space. And I believe most of us here do not have that luxury. So that is one luxury we are providing you from our plant, which you would not have to create on site, waste your land, waste your space for these activities. So that will be taken care of by us through our plant. Those are just 6 benefits, and I have 6 more. Let's start with this slide now. In this benefit, what we are talking about is the other things that we are passing on to you, is the zero installation error. When the production is happening as per the drawings received by the consultant, and the BBS has been approved, again, by the consultant and the site people, whatever is being produced is actually going to be installed without any error. What happens on the traditional methods or manual methods is, manually people are producing as per their sweet will. They try to do it, but they miss out on the actual sizes and shapes, and there are a lot of installation errors that happen on site. With these smaller shapes and sizes produced, the transportation becomes much easier. Apart from just using the smaller vehicles that can actually also be transporting during the day. So if there is a day requirement, we know that the bigger transport is not able to move during the day. The smaller tempos or the chota hathi, where these stirrups and the small shape, the small cuts can go, can help you procuring material in small quantities during the day as well, so that day activity also is going on at the site. Apart from that, as an additional service from us, we are providing GPS-enabled lorry loaders, which will carry the material from our plant to your site, and also it will unload the material at the site up to a height of 12 meters. So that is a facility wherein you do not have to engage into the unloading activities at site and have to get into the hassles of managing probably the Mathadi labor issues as well. Apart from just giving you the ease of transportation, as we were talking about earlier, one of the biggest hassles that one faces on a site is the labor management. That gets totally covered, at least for the steel cut and bend from our site, because we are providing you holistic on-site installation by our own team. So we've got the fixers or the fitters, if we talk in the local slang, that are available with us, and we can do that for you if that is your requirement. Not just doing the installation part, it is saving you the hassle, because as I had shown you earlier, with our safety precautions, with the measures that we have, we ensure that it's 100% safe, accident-free site operation. So you have a lot of headache that gets saved. And I was talking to one of the developers earlier, and he said the benefit of having FCR would be, if I already have 50 things to do, and you give me the 51st thing, I don't think FCR will do anything for me. You make 50 to 49 or 45, then we've got something to talk about. That's what we are trying to do. We're going to reduce your troubles so that you are able to do better things, and you are able to focus more on what you need to be doing is brand building and other activities that are more important on your platform. In the labor hassles, we are not just talking about taking away the installation cost probably, or the cost is still going to be there. It's actually going to happen in a more professional way. Plus, there is no hassle on you from the statutory requirements. That is our concern, and we, as I had shown earlier, we are very strong on statutory obligations, that we are abiding by them with regards to ESIC and PF, which are not necessarily taken care of by the local contractors usually working on site. Coming to the next point, that's the precision cut and angles, which is depicted again on those boards there. These precision cut and angles, because it is an automated technique which is fed into the machine, they will get precisely what you have fed in, which is again not possible by a manual or traditional method. This is, why is this required? Because if you are wanting to make strong structures, reliable structures, we have to have the precision cut and angles as already reflected in the IIT Kanpur study as well. One important aspect for anybody, if I am a buyer, is probably the kind of steel that has been used in making the building where I'm going to be living in. Because from what I understand, if I were to look at the raw RCC structure, I would look at it in such a way, if the building is the body, the RCC structure is the bone, is the skeleton. If the RCC structure is the skeleton, the steel rebar or the reinforcement are actually the bones of the building. Now, if the bones of the building are to be strong, only then the building can be strong. For that, superior quality steel has to be used, and through the automated plant, we only use the primary steel which has been produced using virgin iron ore. And if that is the case, it definitely has higher strength and higher ductility, which is required for this greater strength of the structure. So we are dealing, as I said, we are already the consignment agents for Steel Authority of India Limited and Rashtriya Ispat Nigam Limited, as well as we have tied up to JSW for steel procurement and delivery through the automated plant that we have set up. All of that I talked about would not make much sense if we do not have the numbers associated with it. Now, this is just one simple number analysis that we have done. Of the 12 benefits, I picked up one, or the top one, which is no wastage on site. So currently, in the traditional method, as again reflected through my different discussions when we were working on this presentation and through the different people that I discussed, some of them present here, usually traditional method wastage, and on an average, is 7% of the total material that is procured for the site. At our plant, we are only reflecting a wastage, or we are only seeing a wastage of 2%. It's actually 1.5, but we have still considered it 2% for ease of calculation. What I had said about is waste, no wastage on site, is simply to say there is no wastage on site, but this 2% is the wastage at our plant, so not at the site. So that's not to confuse. Earlier I was saying 0, and now I'm saying 2%. So the earlier message was there is no wastage on site, which we still are saying. But what happens is on the wastage at the plant front is only 2%. So if I was to deploy the machinery at the site, you would see only 2% versus the traditional method, which is doing 7%. What that means is you are getting a benefit of 5%. There's a saving of 5% just from one benefit. You're saving 5% of the total cost. And that would lead to a gain of 1,750 per metric ton of steel that you have procured for your site. So that's based on the calculation for steel as on 29th of Feb for primary steel. So this gain is just reflected out of one benefit that we talked about. If I were to add all the 12 benefits that are reflected here, so I believe these gunny bags and this lady would have much brighter a face. The gunny bags would really fall short of the kind of benefits that we are talking about, the kind of that we are passing on to you. A solution is good if it can give you cost saving, but it is the best if it can give you cost saving as well as higher profit. Not just because of the cost saving, because you get higher sales. The way we understand in management, profits come from saving costs and higher sales. Mostly people talk about either this or that can happen. What we are giving you is both the sides. How is that? What we are talking about in this slide is because of the higher productivity. Again, I'll just take one point out of the benefits we are passing on to you. The higher productivity would lead to the greater speed of delivery for your projects, which is directly proportional to the trust of the buyer or the principal employer, either way you look at it. If there is a greater trust of the buyer, that again is directly proportional to the loyalty towards your brand. Once the brand loyalty increases, that means the strength of your brand increases. A higher brand strength, everybody knows, means higher profit. If you see the big ads in these newspapers of all the developers of the project. It is because everybody wants to create the brand image in everybody's mind. Through our activity, that is easily happening to you. We're giving you higher brand strength, leading to higher profit. And that is why, of all the taglines that we could think of, the best I feel is Apni Pehchan Badhao, is what we are trying to give you from First Choice Rebar Shaping Solutions at Taloja. So once again, I'll summarize that. We are not just passing on the cost saving benefit, we are passing on higher sales to you as well. Because we're not going to be doing the sales for you, but because of the benefits that we are giving to you, you are able to create a higher brand value in the market, which automatically leads to higher sales. So profit and cost saving, no better solution than this that you could come across. What next for us? We are thankful that today you've gathered here to listen to us for what we have just started. And currently we're producing 60,000 tons per year from sizes 8mm to 40mm. What we have planned is a capacity expansion to 2.4 lakh metric tons by the next year in 2017. How will that happen? Through presence of these in all the regions of India, north, east, west, we have already come, and South India. So we'll be able to, as I was talking to one of our August present attendees here, he was talking about having sites across India. So we are looking at already covering the requirements throughout the Indian landscape, as we have done through our train deployment services, where we are already present at 30 sites in the country. That sums it up. I'll once again thank you for being a very nice audience, and sorry for the long wait. And thank you for listening to me. It's been a pleasure presenting to you. And now we'll be opening the house to discussions and questions. And it'll be really good if we could have a very healthy discussion here on how we can probably serve you in the best possible manner so that we pass on these cost benefits and these profits at the earliest possible. Thank you. Questions, or anybody who's got a point who would like to reflect on whatever I just said, or anybody who would like to grill me on the number, probably. We have one hand.
I have sites across Bombay and small 1,000-meter site to 10,000-meter site spread at different levels. So is there something like a minimum quantity which you always look at this way? Because generally my labor contractor would not prefer this in the start. He would look at this as a loss of revenue for him in one sense. So is there a minimum quantity which you really look at, or can I really look at from very small site to all the big sites for this?
Yes, you can definitely look at from small sites to big sites, because we've got our own plant, right? So we have the production capacity that can cater to small as well as big requirements. So that will not be a problem. If you're looking for smaller requirements as well, that will be definitely catered. As I was talking about, in the ease of transportation point, we're able to cater to the smallest requirements also, which can go through a Chota Hathi, which would be about 5 tons at the most, right? So those requirements are also manageable, provided, again, that we are looking for a long-term association. So it's not a one-time activity that we would be looking at, and we can definitely discuss that once we post this launch event, we can have a discussion. Yes, sir. Mr. Kela. So we've got beams as well as slabs. Just to ensure that the presentation becomes too long, I stuck to one point. Otherwise, we have the shear line, as I showed the machinery. The shear line is for cutting of the steel rod. The steel 12 meters is usually the length that you receive. So that can be cut into different lengths as required for the columns. So it covers both the columns and the beams for both requirements, the stirrup as well as the long length. Thank you. I'd just like to add to that. We are also the first in the country to actually have a 16 mm coil stirrup making machine at a plant. There is one more machine probably, which is, and yes, as Dr. S. N. Rao has already clarified, they're already into the production of coil. They're already planning to produce coil very soon, which will be up to 20 mm. So we will also make sure we get the machines in time for 20 mm coils as well. But the 16 mm coil machine, we are the only ones who currently have it. We can produce stirrups of 16 mm as well to the machine that we already have at our plant. Yes, sir. Right.
Can you enlighten on that?
The cost against the production, just the processing part? Just the processing part?
Yes, it's on site. If I have a traditional system,
right?
So I bring a steel, I have a labor camp, all those things are there. There is a cost to it.
Right.
Somebody has to work it out.
Right.
As against, if I'm going for that, see, that is the main selling point.
True.
To a contractor, to a developer,
right?
How much we are saving in terms of, you have to convert a soft cost into an actual cost.
Right.
So that is what a comparative number you should give.
Sir, on that comparison front, it is actually difficult to provide a concrete number to such a vast audience because every site, every condition is different. And it all depends from site to site how much cost or how much saving we can pass on to you. But if I were to say the cost of processing, the cost of processing by the machine would rather be comparable to what you're doing in the traditional method, just the cost of processing. But because of the other benefits that we are passing on to you in, with regards to the one slide that I've shown, the savings that would reflect on the site would actually lead to the huge saving number that we would be able to work out on an individual site-to-site basis. So if we were to get a basic understanding of what the site conditions are, the requirements are, the plan, the schedule, so all those factors once put in, we can come to a comparable number or the comparison that you would like to see between the traditional and the automated method.
But I think
what we have done in our internal calculations, we do feel that it would lead to at least a saving of about 4,000 metric tons per site on an average on the different sites if we look at.
But if you calculate all those monetary wise, it will be a huge saving.
Absolutely.
Sir, because this has, yes, sir.
It is this labor query that how much you save on because the labor, it is coming to about 300 rupees per ton. 300 rupees per ton saving by avoiding these extra labor. Build the housing colonies, security, the water, sanitation.
That is the number that has been calculated, but as I said, it is hard to actually put a direct number or a concrete number for such a vast audience.
But obviously,
because the requirements
benefits will be fair or more.
See, as a marketing tool, I am
now in your shoes.
Yeah, as a marketing tool, you have to give a range because that is what the selling point.
Right. So as I said, on an average, we have worked out that the savings definitely be to the tune of 4,000 metric tons, or between 4,000 per metric ton. That is what is our understanding, the calculation.
Okay.
I do not take that number again because I would leave a lot of confusion and questions that would not be possible to answer for the community. The question is very relevant. I would like to advise as a marketing tool for every person, I believe, the ultimate cost is the same, which is which would not. Yes.
The architect and yourself, because it has all the permutations and combinations of when the material, if the procurement is on your side, those plans would have to be worked out. But the bar bending schedule related to that will be developed by our team, and the plans would be subsequently worked out.
I am sorry that I was late and
not
I could not listen your earlier part of the presentation.
My question is that, can you supply the reinforcement which is having anti-corrosive treatment?
Yes, sir, we can do that as well. But there's right now the anti-corrosion treatment is happening at different outside location, which can be done, which we can provide as a special additional service. However, there's another provision with the SCR that has Mr. Arth can explain, which does not require any further treatment. So if we make the stirrup or the cut and bend. It's again a very relevant question. I believe it's actually very relevant to everybody here, because the corrosion resistance usually comes up in projects where the material has to be very strong. So they go for the epoxy coating, which is a very high cost of about...
Because you see the environment here in Mumbai is quite hostile.
Absolutely, absolutely. Primarily, this is the supplier that we are dealing with. And there are other possibilities of the other primary scheme supplier. Right. Sir, the provision is there. Yes, absolutely. Absolutely. The provision for us to procure on your behalf, on the builders or developers or the project's behalf, is already there. That is again the selling point that we are bringing here, that we will be procuring the steel also if the client requires that we procure the steel, process it, deliver it at site.
And install it.
All the steps we are willing to cover, and we've already made the provisions to cover. Beyond the tonnage? On the tonnage of the finished good. It's like basically you go to buy the shirt, right? So the number of shirts you bought it, you pay for that. How much cloth is used for it? Nobody cares. So that's the basic system. No matter how much steel we have procured for actually producing it, it'll actually be on the BBS. Because we'll also only procure the steel which is required as per the BBS. So our cost to the client will cover the 2% waste that we are facing at the site. Include that waste. I would like to say 24 hours would be the time, but again, it all depends from site to site because it is dependent on what the kind of the requirement is. So the BBS will have to be produced according to the requirement, which might take less time, or which might take a little
like,
more time.
For a project, we may have around 30 to 40 drawings. And for each drawing, you would require to prepare a BBS.
Right.
And all those drawings will be coming, you know, progressively.
Absolutely.
So there should be some, you know...
As the drawings come in, they're right away going... If you're providing us multiple drawings, right, there'll be multiple people acting on the... working on the BBS. It is not that we'll work on the drawing one by one, that one person will do one BBS, then once that BBS is done, then somebody else will work. We have multiple people working on the BBS for multiple drawings for the same site. So we'll cover on the time there. And that should not be a problem. But giving an exact number of how much time one BBS will take, again, is a vague thing to actually answer. Right?
And it will be got approved from the structural engineer.
Yes, we would be getting it approved from the structural engineer of the client, and as well as the client. After the structural engineer approves it, the client signs it off, then it goes into production. Yeah, this is all actually happening through the optimization software, optimization and production software, which covers the BBS scheduling as well as the optimization and the production activity. It's all an automated process, with obviously the manual intervention of using the software. So So Ladad, you might want to add to that. You sure? Mr. Divakar, if you have anything to ask us about this specific activity or what L&T is already experiencing. I'm sorry to trouble you. You have a sore throat, but still, if you could give us 2 minutes.
So good evening, Mrs. Tharajan Associates and senior dignitaries of various reputed organizations presiding over here. Kindly bear with me, I have got a very, very sore throat today and I could not say no to Agarwal and I'm ready to strain my throat now. Yeah, we have been associated with the Tharajchand group for the past 2 years or so, and especially in the crane hiring. We have the cranes deployed in our Goa Panji bridge project as well as nuclear power corporation of this Gujarat, Kakrapara. They've been rendering us very excellent service and very cordial relations we have. And I hardly remember any instance that I had to call the top brasses here for any of the problems in this site. That is what the quality of service they have provided. And we look forward to have more association with them in the coming future projects as our infrastructure booms now. And is the new unit what they've started, this is TIRUP, the steel unit, and hope to have more association with you. And I take this opportunity to thank you for the invitation, and I wish you all the best in your future endeavors, and thanks and best wishes again.
Thank you, Mr. That's highly motivating.
Sorry to just add that I am a HKD worker from L&T Construction in Plant and Machinery heading here in Mumbai, and I have with me left Mr. Govind Vagralkar. He is our one of our senior colleagues. He is heading a procurement, and we both operate from Powai office. Thanks again.
Thanks a lot for making it out tonight, and thanks a lot for the words of appreciation and motivation. Any other questions or anything else you would like to ask, or as I said earlier, if there anybody else who wishes to grill on the questions, on the numbers. Thanks a lot once again, and it's beautiful to have an audience who asks such wonderful questions and clarifies the doubts. And also it's given us a lot of the feedback that we needed, like there was a wonderful point on what a marketing tool or marketing strategy could possibly be. So thanks again for the questions, which have helped us to learn further so that we can improve while we move forward with this venture. Before I end with this, I'd like to request the chairman to please present the bouquet to Mr. S.M. Maheshwari to welcome him. We couldn't do it earlier because of him getting locked in really bad traffic. Now I'd like to request Mr. Sameer Agarwal, President, Tharajchand Logistics Solutions, please convey the vote of thanks.
Good evening, everybody. It's a privilege to deliver the vote of thanks on behalf of Tharajchand Industries Limited. I have been associated with the company for the last 25 years, and I've been taking care of the crane deployment section of the company from the last 25 years. So I am very thankful to everybody who have taken such a pain and coming all the way to grace this occasion and to be a part of the launch of the ceremony of our First Choice Rebar. This First Choice Rebar was the brainstorm of our MD, and we hope that this, what he has promised, is delivered. And I would like to specially thank Dr. S.N. Rao, who has come specially from Visakhapatnam. Thank you very much, sir. RM of RNL, Mr. Ars, all the branch managers who have made a point to attend this meeting. I would also like to thank all the infrastructure projects customers who have gathered here, especially L&T, ITD, and all other, and all the builder friends and the consultants. I once again extend my deep gratitude and thanks to you for coming and gracing this occasion. And with this, we will be coming to the conclusion of this program. Have a very good night and a very wonderful and good weekend. Thank you very much. And let's please join us for the cocktails and the dinner, please. Thank you very much once again. Thanks. Sorry, I would like to thank Mr. Himanshu, our CEO, who has worked so hard. So I request everybody to clap because he is the whole soul for this presentation and he has been doing this regularly and we are really thankful to him. I would also like to extend my thanks to Mr. S. Ramachandran, who has taken so much from the last 2 days. He has been motivating us and been sharpening our skills. Thank you, sir, and hope to see you once again. Thank you, sir. Thank you.